home.
Michael, you know, you guys have been there. This was your home. And we're not talking about communities changing. What we're talking about, communities being destroyed. When you know, we're getting letters from people in Wilkes-Barre and saying they're pouring their heart out and they're saying, mm-hmm. you know, we're watching our not change. It's not demographically changing because all communities change. We're watching our communities and places where we've lived just being destroyed, and why are we letting it happen? Where is, and I'll keep going back to it, where has the Times Leader been? Where's the citizen's voice? Are they going into these communities with the cameras? Maybe they are, maybe they're not. I don't know. I mean, but you know, once light is shown on these things, Michael, it does make a difference. I mean, you're from Wilkes-Barre, you've seen those communities now destroyed. Mm-hmm.
You, Lou, in where I grew up was on Oak Street, 21 Oak Street, and I went back to just visit the neighborhood and knew somebody still living there. And Lou, when I grew up, the kids were out on their bikes, that the parents could feel safe that they can go inside and do what they had to do. It was a wonderful, wonderful community. Now everybody is hunkered down in their homes. You know, where I live, I understand there's probably, you know, drug trafficking out of that house. There's no reason for it. And one of the things that I think Frank touched on was that, you know, we outnumber the evil. We just need to step up. We need to step up and saying we're going, you know, the old phrase that, you know, evil only succeeds if good men and women do nothing. Right. And that's where we're at right now, Lou. Are we going to stand up as good, honest, law-abiding citizens and say, enough, Lou, enough. We're going to be part of something that's going to make a difference to improve our lives.
Bingo. I couldn't have said it better myself. You know, and we're giving people a catalyst. And once again, you know, we have a couple months. The elections are coming up. You got some fresh faces. I encourage folks to look at those fresh faces. You want to stay with the good old boy system, stay with it. But you know what? Let's reawaken that Michael, I said it from the beginning, and it has nothing to do with the Tea Party per se, but I remember those folks when I first went on tour with them. They across the board. And it was about they were just fed up, they were tired, they wanted good government, they wanted people to be honest. That's what we're asking for is folks to be honest. And we need to get that reawakened. We need to relight that. And part of that relighting is the opportunity to give people a voice to say, you know what, I got a story. And somebody's going to print it. Because those crazy folks down at the Gazette is going to print it, and they're going to be able to pick them up, Michael, here very soon, this month coming up, on the square, in the boxes, and your stories will be told. And the only way we can continue to do this, and it's like any other business, is we're asking people to subscribe to our stuff. You could go to Muckraker News. It's a lousy $48 for the whole year. Hey, what have they done for you? That, besides getting you aggravated, folks, if you're listening, what have some of these newspapers done for you besides getting aggravated when you pick it up and say, you know what, I can't stand what they're printing, and yet you're spending the $2 every day. Think about it.
Well,